Sean Brown. I'm a resident of the city of Camden. I'm a recent graduate from Rutgers University, getting my master's degree in public policy. As the chairman said, I also work for Media Mobilizing Project. That's my daytime job. But today I actually speak on behalf of young adults in the city of Camden and throughout the state of New Jersey as the founder of Younger Urban Leaders, an organization that focuses on leadership development for young adults. As we think about this budget for the next fiscal year, there's a few things I wanted to share with you. First, although this committee and the Assembly and Senate have done its job, the Affordable Housing Trust Fund needs to be replenished. I come across many young people who have issues as they reach adulthood and find an affordable place to live, either in their own community where they're from in Camden or moving to the suburbs. If you think about the income that you get when you're fresh out of college compared to the actual cost of rent, it's really difficult to find a safe place to live that is affordable, and I think that this committee and the state has done all that they can to replenish the fund. Health insurance is the second big issue that comes up, whether it's questions about the Affordable Care Act and young people asking how they can sign up for insurance if they aren't with their parents. But the issue comes up more commonly is related to dental and vision care. So as you know, even if you do have health insurance through the ACA, that doesn't speak to dental and vision issues. So there are hundreds of people who have, they need a root canal or their wisdom teeth are growing in. They have a rotten tooth, and there are not a lot of places for them to go to get free dental care without already having insurance in place. But the last and most important issue that I wanted to bring to your attention, committee, is about higher education. In the city of Camden alone, there are 9,000 adults that the Census Bureau calls, refers to their education as some college, no degree. These are people who started in college, one semester, two semesters, three semesters, dropped out for whatever reasons. It could be family issues. Maybe they didn't like school. They found out that wasn't their thing. A numerous amount of issues. But they find that once that 19-year-old had dropped out of college, by the way, without ever having to talk to a human being, because you can do so online, they withdrew, they owe debt, they now don't have a good job, but they do have debt. And when they wanted to try to get back into a community college, the way to get back in is way more difficult than the way it was to get out. Whether it's Camden County College or many of the universities throughout the state of New Jersey, they are not set up in a way that makes it where it's easy for a person who's dropped out, that's not on satisfactory academic progress, has a way to get back in where they can pay off the debt that they owe, but also be qualified for financial aid so that they can go to school tuition-free in real time, meaning that their professional outlook is greatly limited because they don't have the credential that's necessary for them to have a successful life in this area. I think this is low-hanging fruit. This is something that I've tried to bring to the attention of community colleges over the years, and I think it's something that the Assembly and Senate can take a look at as we try to create an economy where people are not prosperous but have the right credentials for employment.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. You mentioned you've spoken to local officials. We're talking about Camden County College.
Yes, I mean, I wrote my graduate thesis on the topic of college completion. When I started the leadership organization, I found that although a lot of young people wanted to be leaders, they wanted to be involved in their communities, they also wanted decent jobs. And most people think that the pathway to do that is either finish with a college degree or to get a credential and some type of certificate program. Well, obviously, if you come from a poor family, which all of my members do, then you need either financial aid or a loan to be able to pay for that. So the problem with financial aid is that once you go to college and drop out, to be able to get financial aid the second time around is really difficult. And college itself doesn't really help in that process. If you happen to know who to talk to at the right time, on the right day, then you might be okay. But if a lot of people they're embarrassed, they don't know who to talk to, they do work a job where it makes it difficult for them to get to the school between 8 and 4, maybe no one answers the phone, it does make it more difficult to get back in and finish that